There may be several reasons that you'll want to reinstall Windows 10 on a computer that already has Windows 10 installed. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to reinstall Windows 10 using the built-in utility from beginning to end, so stick around. Sometimes the built-in utility doesn't work and you may be forced to use a bootable CD, DVD, or USB. I've got a video that shows you exactly how to do that I made a few years back. I'll have linked below and above here. So let's have a look at my computer and I'll show you exactly how to do this. We're inside Windows 10. We're going to click the Start button and go to Settings. Scroll down to the bottom under Update and Security. And then here we've got the Recovery on the left side. We've got two options here. One is resetting this PC. And you would hit get started. The other is the advanced startup, which allows you to do a few other things which you might want to consider for troubleshooting before doing a reset, but we're not going to do that in this video. That'll be for another video. If you're interested, let me know in the comments below and I can show you some of the advanced troubleshooting. We'll go in to get started, and from here we've got two options. One of them is to keep your files, which is very convenient, so you don't have to worry about backing up and restoring the files afterwards, but it does wipe out all the programs and apps and settings, so you will have to reinstall all your programs. So if you're using this for your own personal use, you can do this. It's convenient. Take a backup anyway. Or if you're going to be wiping this to give it away to someone else, then I strongly recommend removing everything. We're going to go to remove everything. And now you've got a couple more options. You could do the cloud download, which will download and reinstall Windows using the latest version, or the local install, which will use the software for reinstalling based on what's on the device currently. This is a lot faster. The cloud download would be more up to date, but it does take some space and it will take time depending on the speed of your internet connection. For the purpose of this video, we're going to assume that you have the latest version of Windows, or the latest version of Windows 10 specifically, and so it's just going to reinstall that version of Windows 10. So we'll go to the local reinstall and it confirms what it's going to be doing. The current setting is to remove the apps and files but not to clean the drive and then reinstall Windows. Let's have a look at the change settings. This is changed from previous versions. You have to go into change settings to see this information where you can clean the data. And as I mentioned earlier, one of the reasons you might be doing this is because you're giving it away to someone else. So you would definitely want to turn this on in that case. So it makes it a little more difficult for anyone to do a data recovery and get your data back even though you wiped it. And then you have an option again, they're asking you to download Windows, to reinstall Windows from this device, or turn it on and it will download the copy. So even though we were prompted earlier, it's prompting us one more time just to make sure that we are sure of our options. So we're going to leave that and let it clean the drive and we'll hit confirm. So it tells us here what it's going to do, including cleaning the drive. So that's great. We'll go ahead and hit next. So it starts preparing to remove it, and it confirms what it's going to be doing. We'll hit reset, and it now starts preparing to do the actual reset. Now we've gotten to a point in the installation where it's asking us to select some options. So let's go through them. First, it's asking about the region. So I'm in Canada. So I am going to scroll up. Select Canada and hit yes. And then it asks about the keyboard. If it's right, usually it's correct. It's US, even though if you're in Canada, it's still US. You may find other options that may apply to you, but it's not the language, it's the keyboard. So you have to look at what type of keyboard you have. If it's a US English keyboard, you would select US, and that's usually what it is. So we would hit yes, and we're not adding a second keyboard layout, so we'll skip that. Next, it asks us for a license agreement that we have to accept. They expect you to scroll through and read the agreement. And assuming you've read that and you agree, you accept. You don't have much choice if you want to continue. Now you can choose how you're setting it up. If it's for personal use, which is usually the case, or if it's for an organization, then you would be doing that through your company, and there'll be other access through there. But for the most part, you're setting it up for personal use, which would be through a Microsoft account, the way you sign in, versus a company where you're signing into a server in a domain network environment. Next, you'll be able to sign in. So if you want to sign in with your Microsoft account, you'd put in your email address and then go through and add your password. But if you don't have a Microsoft account and you want to sign in with one, you can create one straight from here. But if you want to be offline, which means you can still have internet access on the computer, you're just not signing into Microsoft as you sign into the computer. You're just going to have a local username and password. So that information is stored locally on the computer only. So we would choose offline account in that case. And then here it's asking us to sign in to enjoy a full range of Microsoft apps and services. So they're really encouraging you to hit next and say, okay, I changed my mind, I'll sign in with Microsoft account. No, I want the limited experience. Now I can put in my name and hit next. And I can put in a super secret password. And let's try not putting a password, just in case you wanted to do that. And it does allow us to go without a password, but I strongly recommend that you do have a password. Now there's going to be a series of questions here asking yes and no, or basically a question on the top and a question on the bottom. And I would say, if you don't understand what any of this means, then after you read it, and if you really don't know, then you would just choose the second option here, which is basically the more private option. The top option here gives you these benefits, but it is less privacy. So it's totally up to you. But as far as them using your location, you're going to have these benefits, but I would say, no, I don't want anyone to know my location. And finding your device, it's great if you lost it, but they have to track you in order to know that. So if you don't want tracking, say no. And again, the top option for diagnostic information, it'll send everything, or just the required diagnostic data. Inking and typing. So this is other services. You don't need to have any of these things. You can say no to everything. Advertising. And now it asks about Cortana. A lot of people I find are not enjoying that, so we would say not now. And now we're back into Windows, and we've completely done a fresh install of Windows. If you chose the first option of keeping your data, then your data would simply reappear. You would see it there on your desktop and in your documents. But if you chose to wipe it, including wiping the data, then it will be fresh and clean, just like this. you'll be prompted with Edge, which they've been doing for the last few versions. If you say maybe later, it's going to keep bugging you, but you can say get started. It takes a moment preparing, and they want to encourage you to sign in, but you don't have to. Again, you can be offline. So we'll hit complete the setup. And here it is, sign in to sync the data if you want to synchronize between your various devices or continue without signing in. And now we have our Edge browser set up and a fresh copy of Windows.
So that's it for this quick tutorial, and I hope you guys did find it helpful. If you did, please do hit that like button. Consider subscribing and ring the bell to be notified every time I come out with a new video, tutorial, or live stream. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.